water is going to be shut off tomorrow. Now, you may have noticed the road work they've been doing up there, actually improving the sewer system, the water system, but it doesn't mean that they have to shut things off tomorrow so they can put everything back up. So obviously, without water, we have some things that we have to deal with. Our cafeteria, we're all set. We're gonna have a special treat for all of you. We're ordering pizza. We have gluten-free pizza as well. Carrot stick, fruit. We're storing up all of the water today down there, milk and so forth. The bathrooms are a different issue, so listen very carefully. Now, this is Haman pointed out. I thought this was brilliant. For her, she's very involved in global studies. And our connection to global studies on the other campus. When our students at the middle and upper school visit foreign countries, they often notice they don't have facilities like we do here. They don't have access to running water everywhere. Sometimes boys and girls, families, will have to travel many miles just to get water that they can bring back. And sometimes they don't have access to even fresh water. We're going to use this as a bit of an example of what a third of the world faces on a daily basis. We are going to flush all the toilets regularly. You can do that by pouring water down the toilets. And we're going to do that. But we need your help in making sure that you are using the bathrooms appropriately, washing your hands, not making a big deal out of this tomorrow. And we will focus on making sure that your experience is as smooth as possible for a campus that doesn't have water. And I think we can do it. I think we can do it without much trouble at all. So with your help, all day long, I would suggest that you bring a water bottle because we're not going to have access to the drinking fountain. I think we can do this. We can get a small glimpse of what it's like in a foreign country that does not have access to water all the time. And it may give us greater appreciation for having water. So be looking for that tomorrow. Senior kindergarten, where are you? That was a fantastic open house last week. You did such a great job. Congratulations to all of you from all of us. Student Council, we will meet tomorrow morning at 8 o'clock, and we're looking forward to continuing the good work of Student Council. This will be our second meeting with that group. Ahorita vamos a tener la frase de la semana.
If you can squish down a little bit so the boys and girls behind you can see. down. Thank you, everyone. Welcome to our opening ceremony. I'm going to turn the mic over to...
best weeks ever. We get to learn about different cultures while having fun.
Whoa, look at these awesome t-shirts.
Yes, they are pretty cool, and we get to wear them the whole week.
You can also wear any cultural clothing you might have.
This week we have special guests, amazing performances, and more.
Do you guys know anyone from a different culture? Well, this week is a perfect time to celebrate different lifestyles and people from all around the world.
This event would never be fun without our wonderful Miss Tina and Miss Tina. We hope you all have a fun and learn a lot about this event.
Thank you.
Thank you. And now for our flag ceremony.
Thank you.
when you're talking. Someone near you is still talking to you. All right, I think we're ready. This is RJ. for our JK and SK veterans team. Now, if you boys and girls can join the boys and girls sitting down, and we can have those boys and girls scoot back a couple scoots, SK can go back to their class. SK this way. And if we can have our third for fifth grade choral student. Fifth grade choral student.
Dismiss. If you would look to your teachers, please. Have a wonderful week.